You are now listening to Vigilantes Radio, presented by the Only One Media Group. This is the people's choice for quality interviews, celebrities, and special guests. Hosted by Demetrius-Reynolds. Call in to join the mix at 701-801-9813. For the complete archive of episodes, visit onlyonemediagroup.com and be sure to like us on Facebook at Vigilantes Radio. We welcome all. Enjoy the show. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your host, Demetrius Whodini-Blak Reynolds. Enjoy the show.
Well, hello, hello. What is going on, guys? Again, welcome to another incredible episode of Vigilantes Radio Live right here on iHeartRadio. And I am your host, Dini. We have another special guest, so you definitely want to stick around for that. And as a matter of fact, text your buddies, family members, or even share it on social media right now and let them know that we are about to dive deep into another interview. Before I bring my guest on, I do want to say, in every unknown, I see an opportunity to learn, and for that, I am grateful. When challenges arise, I embrace them with gratitude, for they are chances to grow stronger and more resilient. Encountering my limitations is a blessing, as it highlights areas where I can improve sometimes. And, you know, I feel tired and weary, just like all of you. But to me, that's a sign of me being impactful. And for that, I'm truly thankful. Making mistakes is a part of the journey, and I'm grateful for them too, as they are clear lessons and what not to do. And so far, I'm still alive and have survived. So, hey, I didn't mess up too bad, right? It's easy to appreciate the good things in life, but I've learned to be thankful for the setbacks as well. The mindset shift allows me to view disappointments in a more positive and empowering light. And it kind of teaches me not to be so self-entitled, you know. Life is an opportunity, no matter which angle it goes. You know, at some point in time, it becomes a choice. Some blessings are immediately apparent, while others reveal their value through the lessons they teach and the growth they foster and the perseverance they instill. Life is a tapestry of blessings, and I am thankful for each one, especially those that challenges me the most. Take that from me, Coach Dini. That is my word, and word is bond.
What's up, guys? It's Dini, and I want to welcome you on a journey of the heart and of the mind. These Fucking Feelings podcast is a beacon in the world of mental health advocacy, and it invites you to join a conversation that's changing lives. We are here to share, listen, and grow together. Led by the passionate Micah Bravery, alongside the insightful Rebecca and Crystal, this award-winning podcast dives deep into the human experience, from navigating relationships to coping with loss. No topic is off limits. It's about real stories and real emotions. These Fucking Feelings is more than just a show. It's a community, a place where vulnerable isn't just accepted, it's celebrated. You can find it across major platforms, including YouTube and Facebook Watch. This podcast is a touchstone for anyone seeking understanding and support. These Fucking Feelings podcast, where every emotion is valid and every story matters. Tune in and transform the way you see mental health.
All right, all right. Again, you're listening to VRL. That's Vigilantes Radio Live right here on iHeartRadio. And I am your host, Dini. Our interviews are designed to go beyond music, news, books, art, acting, films, technology, education, entrepreneurship, entertainment, and sometimes even that thing that we call the ego. Our interviews are designed to go behind the scenes and into the minds of these incredible human beings. You know, the ones who are out there giving it their all for me, for you, and for the world. Well, today we are thrilled to welcome CALYN, a rising star in the alternative R&B scene. Representing Stockton, California, CALYN has captivated audiences with her unique blend of soulful melodies and deep lyrics. Influenced by the legendary SZA, she's quickly becoming known for her innovative approach to popular culture. Her journey in music, nurtured by her family's love for the art and her collaborations with her sister, has led to the creation of emotionally charged single like Waiting, which is a song that we're going to play tonight and talk about. CALYN, passion and dedication to her craft shine through every note that she sings. And with that, let's welcome CALYN. Hello, hello, hello. Welcome.
Hi, how are you? Thank you so much for having me.
Absolutely. Again, welcome to the show. As we've moved further into 2024, you know, we are reflecting on goals, aspirations that are crucial for artists and just anybody in general. But for you, what's the best piece of advice or insight that has guided you in your music career or helped you stay true to your artistic vision and goals?
That's a great question. I think that something that I've always highlighted as I grow in my music career would definitely be the fact that you need to step out of your comfort zone, because although I'm still in the very early stages of my career, I've found that all of the times that I'm making a big step for myself, I had to step out of my comfort zone in order to get to that space. And so it's definitely commonly seen in the music industry that you're asked to do things that you wouldn't originally choose to do yourself. But at the end of the day, you're opening more doors for yourself to get to where you want to be. So I definitely think that that's a strong piece of advice that I would give.
Absolutely. So your music has a deep personal and emotional quality. Can you share with us what drives your creative process and how you infuse your personal experiences into your songs?
Yeah, for sure. I honestly think the creative process really depends on the project. I feel like it's different every time. Sometimes I'll experience something and immediately a concept pops into my head that I want to create into something. And then other times the beat will come first and the concept will come later. And I don't ever plan to make my music so personal, but I think it's kind of a blessing that it has become that.
So let's go back to the beginning, the genesis of everything. How did you discover your passion for creating music?
Okay, so growing up, my sister is 3 years older than me, DYLI. She's an artist as well. And she started creating music when I was probably 6. And obviously it kind of started out as like a, oh, you know, of course I want to do what my big sister does. And I wanted to follow in her footsteps. And then over time, I realized, like, no, this is really what I want to do. And so once I finally started experimenting with different sounds, I was able to tap into my own creative side. And I really realized how much passion I have for my music career and what I'm really planning to do with my life. So I definitely think watching my sister inspired me. And it not only showed me something that I didn't realize about myself, but it's made me more open to trying new things across the board.
Sure. I have a lot of listeners that are young and they're always asking the question about identity. When it comes to your music and your personality, we know you were influenced by SZA and then your bigger sister. Was it hard to carve out your own identity, you know, to separate the influence for who you actually are?
I think in the beginning it kind of felt that way because I was so young when I started creating. And then over time, when I was learning to be media trained, my answer to the question, you know, who are you? Tell the people who you are. It's always, you know, the same cookie cutter answer. My name's CALYN, I'm 17 years old and I'm a musician. But the question that I wasn't able to answer was what kind of musician I was. And so I definitely was following in her footsteps genre-wise at first. And then over time I realized that wasn't the same fit for me. And then I tried a pop route, and I didn't like that either. And it took me a really long time, but I feel like I'm finally defining my own musical personality, if that makes sense.
Yeah. What led you to that point of discovery?
I think it was really just dipping my toes in the water in every direction. And every time I thought that I found my sound, of course, I got older, more mature, and learning myself, it wasn't really just like a from A to B route. It was a lot of experiences that went into it that made me realize. And I'm still open to trying new genres and figuring out I have so much more life left in my career that I do want to try new things, and maybe another sound will come up that I feel like I fit the best. So I definitely think that it's a never-ending process of just creating and learning.
Yeah. In real life, do relationships play a part in that too?
In my creative process?
Yeah, like genre based. Like I remember dating this one person, and you know, they listened to a type of music, and I began to find myself liking the same type of music. And even after the relationship ended, I was still listening to this type of music, or fusing what I was listening to previously, you know, with the new sounds. So I'm saying, like, do shifts in relationships play a role in creative identity when you're finding who you are and finding your sound?
Yeah, absolutely. I think, like, for good and for bad, sometimes I feel like certain experiences, friendship or relationship wise, might shift my perspective on, am I doing this right? You know, or even just points in my career that I don't feel like I'm making enough progress. I question if I agree with the route that I'm taking with my creative process. So it definitely affects it on a day-to-day basis. I don't even think I could define a specific time that it shifted and never changed again. So it's, you know, constantly changing. But that was a really interesting question.
Absolutely. So your single Waiting dives into the complexities of relationships. What inspired this song?
A really long process went into that, songwriting wise, but I'm trying to figure out the best way to explain this without being too personal, but I've definitely had my fair share of experiences in the past year or two that have unlocked a lot of new parts of my brain writing wise, and I think Waiting really shows that, because I've never had such a personal experience put into words like I did with Waiting. And so I started writing it fresh out of a breakup, and then I kind of put it back in the vault, and it really just snowballed after that. And I went back to it so many times until I finally felt like I should release it. But it was revisited with different emotion every time. So I think that's cool about that project, because there's so many different parts to it where the verse I was feeling one way and the bridge I was feeling a completely different way. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yeah. Almost like the roller coaster of those feelings within, like, especially towards the end of a relationship, you know, you may go through like a sad period, and you may go through a angry period, and sometimes a mixture of the two. Not saying that for this track, but you know, the roller coaster of that emotional thing.
Yeah, absolutely. I think that it really did capture that. And I feel also that it kind of creates a relatable space for people to be in, because it isn't, you can apply the lyrics to that song to really anything you want, relationship wise, friendship wise. But across the board, it was definitely a new stepping stone in my career, not only because of the creation of that song and how it was a project that I was proud of, because I created it fully based on my own emotions. A lot of my projects I write with my sister, and that one I wrote fully independently, and then it did a lot for me numbers wise. So I just, you know, I hold that project really close to me, because I definitely think that it marked a shift in my career for the better.
Yeah, congratulations on that. That's phenomenal.
Thank you.
You know. Yeah. Betting on yourself, I really love that too. And then, you know, you hit it out of the park. So you're ready for the next one?
I am. I'm really excited for my next release. It's actually at the end of this month, on the 26th. So because of the numbers I did on my last one, I have been getting asked a lot by, you know, family and friends or people that support my music career, like, oh, you know, you did good numbers on your last one, you have to release again. So it's definitely hyping me up for the release because of the way people have talked about it.
Does that create pressure as well?
Yeah, I would think so. I feel like it's hard to explain because this is definitely a new feeling for me to feel like people are expecting something from me. And that's just because, you know, that's a great thing in my opinion, because the only reason I'm being talked to like that and people are expecting things from me is because I brought what I needed to the table last time around. And so it is like a little bit of pressure, but I think it's more of just like excitement and high hopes to see, you know, how much better can this release do than the last one.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, guys, we're getting ready to jump into the single Waiting, and then we'll be right back. Stay tuned.
Hey, Mac, this the one right here.
Emotional maturity without anyone work for me. You said that you in love, but it ain't a guarantee. Maybe it was the drugs, maybe the Hennessy. But all I know is too sick, there I'm gon' have to be. Gone from all the shit we done had. Tired from trying to make it last, Communicating with you feel like I talk to myself. So I don't know one, but about a back on her. Feel so weak. It's like you wanting to be something I need to beg you to stay. When in reality, it's been on my brain, I'm trying to break it off. Waiting for you to call. Something tells me you don't see this coming. Spend time thinking about it, now I'm running. I know for sure I'm about to break it off. Waiting for this to fall. Waiting, keep driving, hit the wall. It's a brawl, this ain't even nothing small. So I just wait for you to call. This shit ain't no good, it's a habit to think twice. And I know I did it for me, but you always on my mind. So I lay awake at night and wonder what if it went right. Can somebody please remind me why you don't deserve the time to call my phone. I spent 200 days waking up knowing I got you. It's a long, long road. But when I get to the end, I'm reminded why I broke it off. Waiting for you to call. Something tells me you don't see this coming. Spend time thinking about it, now I'm running. I know for sure I'm about to break it off. Waiting for this to fall. Waiting, keep driving, hit the wall. It's a brawl, this ain't even nothing small. So I just wait for you to call.
Feel so weak. It's like you wanting to be something I need to beg you to stay. When in reality it's been on my brain, I'm trying to break it off.
Alright, welcome back again. You just got finished listening to Waiting by CALYN. All right, dope song. Let's go ahead and bring her back. Hello, you're back live with us and in our hot seat. I forgot to mention we have this segment where we invite our guests to perform for us, whether that's spoken word, poetry, rap, singing, telling a joke, telling a story from your life, playing an instrument, or just giving some advice, or doing nothing at all. It's totally up to you. Would you like to participate?
Why not? It sounds like an experience.
All right. Ready when you are.
Okay, I'll sing a little bit from one of my favorite songs right now, Insane by Summer Walker, if that's okay.
Yes.
Now what you in a rush for? What you trying to meet your maker, darling? Or you running out of time, huh? But time ain't even real. You really need to chill. It's all an illusion. You get it mixed up in the future. Whatever it is you trying to see, you can sit down and just believe. But I wouldn't never be the same all day. And I can tell you straight, it ain't no game, baby. Oh, God bless me.
Oh, wow.
I'll stop there.
That was great. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, all right. So, looking. Oh, go ahead.
I said you had me on the spot there.
Ah, yes, that's what we call the hot seat, for sure. So, looking forward, what can your fans expect in terms of new projects or new music in the near future?
So, yearly, it's always a good time to plan, and I always have a great time looking at my year and what in the 12 months am I going to be providing for my audience. So, as I mentioned earlier, I do have a single coming out at the end of this month on the 26th, and then I'm hoping to get around to an EP release soon, and then me and my sister have a couple shows planned, so I'm really looking forward to that. It's hopefully going to be a really productive year, so yeah, a single at the end of the month, and then I'm hopefully able to just continue my streak of releases after that.
Absolutely. Where can our listeners connect with you online?
I am on all streaming platforms. It's CALYN, C-A-L-Y-N in all caps. So Apple Music, Spotify, SoundCloud, YouTube. And then all of my social media is CALYN underscore official, C-A-L-Y-N underscore official.
Hey. And listeners, just in case you didn't get those links, no worries. I will have them in the description of this episode and in the show notes. So all you guys have to do is just click the links. As we conclude our insightful conversation with CALYN, it's evident that her journey in the world of alternative R&B is just beginning. Her passion, creativity, and dedication to her craft are not only inspiring, but also a testament to the power of music as a form of expression. With her unique sound and deep storytelling, CALYN is undoubtedly an artist to watch. So thank you, CALYN, for sharing your experiences and your music with us. To our listeners, keep an eye out for CALYN's upcoming projects and continue to support emerging artists who bring innovation and soul to the music scene. Thank you.
Thank you so much for having me.
Yes, take care.
You too.
Thank you, my Vigilantes family, as always, for checking out my podcast over here at Vigilantes Radio Live. All episodes are available for free download, and you can grab it from either Spreaker.com/Only One Media Group, Spotify, CastBox, iHeartRadio, iTunes, YouTube, the app Podcast Addict, or over at our website, which again is onlyonemediagroup.com. And that goes for every single show that we've ever aired. If you like to request music or send something for me to play, email it to vradio@onlyonemediagroup.com. That is V as in Victor. And here's my disclaimer. We are genre free. We do not judge, and we absolutely do not base our opinions on hearsay, but facts alone. And actually, scratch all of that, because all of my opinions are always right. That's the bottom line. This is my show, so deal with it. Just kidding. On behalf of myself, Denny, I appreciate all you guys for tuning in, either afterwards or live with us. Spread the word, because sharing is caring. We stepped up our game just for you guys and our guests to make sure that you have the best experience here on our show. Be sure to connect with me on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Tumblr, Snapchat, TikTok, and all social media sites, as well as Spreaker, YouTube. We always follow back. Okay, well, just remember to put yourself into everything that you do and never stop investing in yourself. Peace, love, grilled cheese, and talk with you later.
You are now listening to Vigilantes Radio, the people's choice for quality interviews, art, music, and hot topics. Hosted by Demetrius "Whodini-Blak" Reynolds of the duo No Longer the Hero. All episodes of this podcast are available for free download at www.onlyonemediagroup.com. This is a Seventh Sign Regime, Rebirth Worldwide Syndicate exclusive.